गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, नमस्कार सभी को। आई वेलकम डॉक्टर रितु संतवानी मैम ऑन दिस प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ आयुष दर्पण। एज टुडे इज द वेरी ग्रेट सेशन। आई थिंक इट्स अ वेरी यूनिक टॉपिक। वी हैव नॉट डिस्कस्ड मच, बट टुडे डॉक्टर रितु मैम हैज गिवन अस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्पीक और टू लिसन और टू डिस्कस विद मैम। सो आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू ऑन दिस फोरम ऑफ आयुष दर्पण। And before starting or before introducing Dr. Ritu ma'am, I would like to play the Dhanvantari Vandana. And with the blessings of Lord Dhanvantari, we will start our next schedule. So I welcome all in this session. Yes, mujhe host bana dijiye. Yes, are you there?
This is going live on which page of Facebook?
Ayush Darpan journal page.
What do you put? Ayush Darpan?
Yes, Ayush Darpan. I will share the link also, ma'am. Just wait. I will share. Definitely. I just share. I think there is link also. I have provided the link in the message also.
So that is not working. You see, that is not.
Okay. I will revise once again. No issue. Okay. I will. So, Dr. Yash, are you there? Okay, no issue. By praying our Lord Dhanvantari, I think he forget to make me host or co-host. I shall call with him once again. So first, main aapka introduction deti hu tab tak, ma'am. So welcome on this forum.
Thank you, Shilpa.
Yes, Dr. Ritu Santamani, madam, is MBBS MD, Ops and Gynec, and she is a very good speaker and very much active personality. So she is very much dedicated to her work. She is associated with World Society of the Cosmetic Gynecology, Board of Member India, Middle East Association of Aesthetic Medicine and Reconstructive FGM Surgery. Then the director Pune Test Tube Baby Center and Sham Well Woman Clinic. So she is also working as a panel consultant in the Ruby Hall Clinic, which is the best clinic in Pune. Co-host bana dijiye na ya host bana dijiye kuch to, kyunki kuch bhi. Haan, theek hai, okay, koi baat nahi, theek hai, baat nahi karunga. Theek hai, ma'am share nahi kar payegi na speaker ma'am, theek hai. So panel consultant visiting hospitals like Sri Samarth Hospital, Sai Hospital, honorary professor at Ops and Gynec, IMS Medical College, Gajrula. So I think, and she's working in the field last 20 years. So she's having a long experience in the field of gynec and ops. So I welcome Dr. Ritu ma'am on this platform. Welcome ma'am. And today's topic is female sexual dysfunction and infertility.
Thank you so much, Dr. Shilpa, for kind words. Dr. Shilpa, will you please share me, because my so many followers also want to listen, so I can
just a minute. I will. So
before I start, I think I will make it live on my this also, Facebook. Otherwise you can tag me, so then it will also come a notification. I can share that.
Yes. Yeah, I'm just saving.
Everybody,
You can share also Zoom link, ma'am. No issue. You can share also Zoom link. I have sent
Zoom
you the
link. Facebook already link. Facebook. I want to make it live, na, so everyone can see, na.
Okay. No issue. There are so many viewers on this page. Actually, there are 50, around 50,000 viewers are there.
23 years, sir. Okay. 3 years, 12 years. MCB 10 years, and not sterilized. AV 7 to 8 years. Regular cycles, sir. ஆனா வந்து மெயினா ராம்சுத்ரால வந்து ஹிஸ்டரக்டே பிளான் பண்ணிருக்காங்க மேம் இந்த பேஷண்ட்ட அங்க வந்து 1.5 லட்சம் 2 லட்சம் வரும்னு சொன்னாங்க அதனால இங்க வந்து பண்ணிக்கிறேன்னு சொல்றாங்க ஆனா வெறும் 33 இயர்ஸ் தான் மேம் ப்ரீவியஸ் வெல்ஸ் இயர்ஸ் மெரினா கோக்கு பேஷண்ட் செட் ஆகல மேம் 1 மந்த் எடுத்துட்டாங்க மேம்
சரி ஓசி குரூப் போடுது
50
போடுது
பத்மாவதி மேம் ப்ளீஸ்
Only give me a second, I will start.
No, no, ma'am. Just wait for 2 minutes. Also, no issue because okay. There is some technical issue. I will make you co-host, so you can share your screen also. I think you have prepared the PPTs also.
Yeah.
So just we are in the waiting phase. Yes. மேடம் யூ ஹவ் கண்டக்டட் மோர் தென் 1,000 வெபினார்ஸ் சுமித் அண்ட் ட்ரைனிங் அண்ட் அவேர்னஸ் sessions for public corporate and the medical fraternity so Dr. Ritu has written the more than 200 articles and columns for various health journals and newspapers Dr. Ritu have earned without various awards and the recognition to her a significant contribution in the health and the social care services very ma'am very much I think tremendous work you have done
Hello.
Already
thank you so much
Hello.
Of sessions yeah. and 200
of hello
great amazing and it's really nice to see you on this forum on this platform also
thank you so much
working as
will you please mute Achha, all the participants
na because
yeah. some technical issue is there I'm not the host and the host is traveling so Achha, just
payment kyunki aap le lijiye
few minute he will make me also the host and
okay
Can I start, Dr. Shilpa? I have to wait.
You can start, ma'am. Without PPT, you just start with your speech only for few minutes, only 5 minutes.
अब मेरे को वापस छोड़ के लेना पड़ेगा.
Dr. Sarita, please unmute. Please mute कीजिए. Mute कीजिए, please.
Not able to share my screen. Acha, they have
just for 5 minutes, ma'am. Then you just start with your speech.
This is going on Facebook, yeah, or YouTube also. Or Facebook, it is going.
Facebook, it is going, and it will afterwards it will be uploaded on YouTube also.
Okay, so there is some another channel for your YouTube.
Same, Ayush Darpan is there. Ayush Darpan YouTube
okay,
channel.
Okay. So friends, I think all of you are getting the patients of the female sexual dysfunction in your OPD. Yes or no? Now no one is replying. Now earlier there are a lot of noises coming. Now no one is replying. Yes, Dr. Andrew has written yes. Okay. So what's your usual mode of treatment? Please write your comments in the chat box. or you can speak now also till they have not made me the host. So let me let us discuss. Let's watch the modality of your treatment. Did the patient?
Yeah, definitely. So
yeah.
I request all the doctors to participate.
Can Dr. Shilpa, you are host now.
Yeah. I can. I will make you, ma'am, host.
Yeah. Because our discussion will be a kind of the interactive discussion.
Yes, ma'am. You can share now.
Yeah. Let me see. Yeah. Hope slides are visible.
Yes.
So thank you, Dr. Shilpa, for inviting me here. So friends, today we are going to discuss, as Dr. Shilpa has introduced, given the nice introduction for me. So friends, I am very passionate about the knowledge sharing. So all of you can connect with me on any of the social media, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, or the LinkedIn. We are doing lot of this kind of academic activities. So all of you are welcome to join. So now, as we all aware, we have just gone through two bad phases of the corona. So my every presentation will start with Stuti to Mata Durga. Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Chikitsa Rupen Sansita Namastase 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 Namo Namo. So today what we are going to discuss regarding the role of this female sexual dysfunction and infertility. We all are getting so many of patients of this in our OPD. So now how to treat them? What's the basic treatment we have to start? As the patients are coming with the infertility problem, and once we do the proper counseling and take the history, sometimes it comes that either a female sexual dysfunction or male sexual dysfunction. So today my talk will be focused on the female sexual dysfunction. So hope all of you agree with me that earlier it was said the basic need of human being is the roti, kapda and makan. Now it has all changed, like a mobile, free Wi-Fi and sex. So coming to this female sexual dysfunction, it is defined by the WHO, the various ways in which a woman is unable to participate in a sexual relationship as she would wish. So it is a multifactorial, age-related, progressive problem. FSD is defined as a persistent, recurring decrease in sexual desire or arousal, and the difficulty, inability to achieve an orgasm, and or the feeling of the pain during the sexual intercourse. So this is also very important, because sexual dysfunction is not only just a men's world. So many females are coming to us with this problem. So the incidence studies have shown that 40% of the women struggle with this sexual dysfunction. The study has come from the National Health Survey that shows the 43% of the women of the age group less than 60 years had come with some form of the sexual dysfunction. So now the prevalence of this, the individual disorder of sexual dysfunction in premenopausal women ranges from 21 to 28% hyperactive sexual desire disorder, 28% female sexual arousal disorder, while with 23% is the lubrication difficulties, and 21% with the orgasmic, and 26% with the pain. So as we are aware, the factors which affect directly the female sexuality is either the age, physical and emotional health, education of the partner and the patient herself, sexual performance of the partner, what about the hormonal status and quality of the relationship with the partner. So this is a very relevant diagram. Once the male is trying to go for the act, he is reading about the 101 positions, and female is reading about the 102 excuses. So take it all that in the lighter way. So now this female sexual dysfunction, now what are the causes? We can divide into organic, psychological, relationship or socio-cultural factor. So among this organic, we can see the neurological problems, cardiovascular diseases, cancer, gynecological cancers, urogynecologic pathologies, drugs, hormonal disorders. While coming to the psychological, depression, anxiety, history of sexual and or physical assault, stress, alcohol and or drug addiction. While coming to this relationship level, it is also very, very important because so many patients we are getting in our OPD are coming because where I practice in Pune, a metro city, a lot of patients are coming with this complaint regarding some or the other complaint they're having with the partner, performance of the partner, loss of the partner, quality of the relation, loss of specialness. Among this socio-cultural, inadequate education, conflict with religious, personal, family values, and some social taboos. Now, how it is classified? So the classification has been given by the DSM. They are divided this into the four categories. The class one, where the problem in the sexual desire. I think a lot of patients we are getting in our OPD, sometimes the partners are coming that my wife has having now no sexual desire. Another is class two is with the sexual arousal. Another is class three is the orgasmic. Then class four is the sexual pain disorder. So now this female sexual response, the woman's sex drive is influenced by several type of factors, the physical, situational, emotional or psychological. So among this we come the desire, excitement, plateau and orgasm. So now this sexual response cycle, how we divide in the woman consists of five phases, the sexual desire phase, arousal phase, plateau, orgasm and relaxation. So here we can see the desire phase can last for days, fantasies, dreams about the sexual object. Arousal phase can last from 1 to 2 minutes to hours. Plateau phase between 30 seconds to 3 minutes. Orgasm phase 3 to 15 seconds. While the relaxation is for 10 to 15 minutes. In this cycle, there are two basic physiological processes, the vasocongestion and the neuromuscular tension or the myotonia. So the vasocongestion takes place in the lower and upper genital organs and the breast, while the myotonia takes place in the whole body. So here, how we divide is like a hyperactive sexual desire disorder, aversion disorder, sexual arousal disorder, orgasmic, dyspareunia, pelvic floor hypertonus, and some patients these days we are getting of this non-coital sexual pain. Means in these patients are coming and complaining of the genital pain following the stimulation during the foreplay time. So as we know, the sexually sensitive areas here we can see in this the clitoris, vagina, nipples, breast and labium. So here the clitoris and vagina are considered to be the queens of sex. So now, as I have told earlier in the earlier slide, the sexual desire disorder has been divided into hyperactive sexual desire disorder or the sexual aversion. Hyperactive sexual desire, I'm not taking in the detail as everyone is aware. So now all these factors are affecting the fertility potential. So now in sexual aversion, defined as the fear and avoidance of sexual thought and situations, extreme anxiety or the disgust at the anticipation of or an attempt to have any sexual activity. Among the sexual arousal disorder, it is characterized by the persistent or recurrent inability to attain sexual arousal or maintain arousal until the completion of a sexual activity. Female sexual disorder occurs when the body does not respond to sexual stimulation. असले आपल्याकडे भरपूर पेशंट येतात जे सांगतात की हा ज्या टायमाला स्टार्ट केला त्या टायमाला स्टिम्युलेशन होतो मग प्रॉपरली ते पूर्ण राहत नाही. सो मेनी पेशंट्स वी आर गेटिंग ऑफ दिस द पर्सिस्टंट और रिकरेंट इनएबिलिटी टू अटेन और मेंटेन द सेक्शुअल एक्साइटमेंट एंड अदर कैटेगरी इज कमिंग द डिजायर फॉर द सेक्स एंड माइट बी इंटेक्ट एंड माइट हैविंग द डिफिकल्टी इन अराउजल. Now, coming to this orgasmic dysfunction, because this female sexual dysfunction is such a vast topic, over under each heading we can take a separate lecture. So now to compact that, how this female sexual dysfunction is affecting the infertility, I have made in a nutshell for each and everything in this lecture. So among this, the orgasmic dysfunction is a condition that occurs when a woman has difficulty in reaching orgasm or sexual climax, even when both the partners are sexually aroused and there is sufficient sexual stimulation. So here we can see the causes of the love making that consistently ends before the woman is aroused enough, or there is insufficient foreplay, or in one or both partners, lack of understanding about how their genital organs function, poor communication about the sex, for example, about what sort of stimulation a person enjoys. Now coming to this orgasmic dysfunction, the reasons are either maybe problem in the relationship, or fear of letting go or being vulnerable, a physically or emotionally traumatic experience such as sexual abuse, or anxiety about the performance, or sometimes the psychological disorders like depression has been noticed. So now among this female sexual pain disorder, dyspareunia, I think we all are getting lot of patients. So for dyspareunia, and among this is now coming to the vaginismus, which involves the involuntary muscle spasm on the lower third of the vagina that interferes with the intercourse. Now symptoms of this female sexual dysfunction, as we have just discussed, either diminished willingness to engage in sexual activity, a lack of sexual thoughts or fantasies, and the low sexual responsiveness. So among this we are coming either the medical conditions, maybe either due to cancer or mitral stenosis or some other problem, or maybe on some medications or hormonal disorder, while the psychological I have just discussed. So now, which are the diseases that causing the sexual dysfunction? Yes, the diabetes, arthritis, vaginal atrophy, hypertension, neurological disorders, multiple sclerosis, overactive bladder, interstitial cystitis, chemotherapy, radiation to vagina or cervix, coital cephalgia, and the smoking. These all have been reported. So now, what are the hormones which are affecting this female sexuality? So we come one by one. As we all know, the estrogen hormone. How it is affecting, and we all know it is for the sexual identity, for the functional influence and influence to relation. Now coming to this androgen, the basic hormone which have the central influence and triggers. Only one second, I have one just. Androgen, the basic hormones that have the central influence and triggers sexual desire and central arousal, modulate the peripheral arousal, influence the secretion of nitric oxide, increases the clitoral arousal, increase the life energy, induce self-esteem, or influence pheromones. So now coming to that, what are the treatment options are available? So the estrogen, testosterone preparation, other drugs like sildenafil has also been reported. So I will take one by one. So now the study has been supported from this PubMed journal that infertility related distress and female sexual function during the assisted reproduction. So they have divided that vaginismus and dyspareunia are two sexual disorders that are frequently implicated as directly a cause of infertility. So as we know, the vaginismus or hypercontractility of the pelvic floor muscles can cause the significant discomfort during the sexual intercourse. The etiology of vaginismus includes both physical and non-physical factors that are associated with the anticipation of pain during the sexual intercourse. While other, we are coming to this dyspareunia. Dyspareunia or the pain caused by the an attempted or actual vaginal penetration has multiple etiologies. So we all know that so many patients are complaining for this and coming to us with the complaint of the infertility. So here we can see this vice versa. So this painful sex, decreased desire, unsatisfying encounters, decreased arousal, decreased orgasm, and inadequate stimulation. So all this has been correlated and causing this vaginismus. So now there again a study has been quoted by the ACTA Clinica Patricia that infertility and sexual dysfunction have a lot of correlation. So taking this again. Now, what are the other diseases that how it is causing the sexual dysfunction is causing the infertility? Now coming to this PCOS, we all are getting a lot of patients of polycystic ovaries in our OPD. So the studies have shown the PCOS has shown a reduced quality of life, increased risk of depression, decreased overall sexual satisfaction and feelings of sexual self-worth. This may be due to the changes in appearance, acne, hirsutism, weight gain associated with elevated androgen levels, but more research is necessary. Now coming to this endometriosis, so many patients we are getting of this endometriosis. As we all know, endometriosis itself is causing a most commonly among the infertile women. So there are several mechanisms: abnormal peritoneal environment, alterations in the tubal and endometrial function, mechanical obstruction due to intra-abdominal adhesions. Endometriosis is also one of the most common cause of chronic pelvic pain and deep dyspareunia in women due to the presence of the inflammation in the pelvis, adnexal mass or adhesions. Now coming to this premature ovarian failure, a lot of us getting the patients in our OPD for this premature ovarian failure. So patients with premature ovarian failure experience the cessation of ovarian function and decreased sex hormone production, leading to anxiety, physiological distress, depression, decreased sexual arousal or vaginal lubrication, increased pain during intercourse and fewer sexual fantasies. Uterine fibroids, because of a high consistency of endometriosis and fibroids in the infertile population, it is unclear whether the pain reported by the patients with fibroids is solely due to the enlarged uterus. So now coming to a very, very important point, that how we have to manage this. So as I've shown in my first slide, that how to this rekindle the fire. So we are coming one by one. F to fuel up the desire, I to increases the blood flow to genitals, R for relieves the stress and anxiety, E is for ensuring the maximum strength and stamina. So now men versus women, how to the approach towards the sex. So there is a very famous quote from the Bell Crystal that women need a reason to have sex while men just need a place. A light bulb gets turned on with a flick of a switch almost instantly and instantly turns off, leaving you in the dark. While for the men, the sexual arousal is an instant as their mental detachment from the sex after the ejaculation. While for the females, see, we got this very beautiful quote, while you turn on the iron, it heats up gradually. Once you turned off, it evenly slowly cools. So women get need to at least 15 minutes or more to be sufficiently aroused for the orgasm. So now how we have to manage this female sexual dysfunction? So first of all, very important is the lifestyle modification. We all know these days so many patients are coming with the smoking and alcohol. So cutting off smoking, excess alcohol and illicit drug use, reduction in the weight in cases of obesity, optimal treatment of the medical diseases like hypertension, diabetes, Exercise, healthy diet, and adequate rest, of course, very important. The woman and her partner need to improve the communication and reduce the relationship strains. So this is for that only, quitting for the alcohol and the smoking. So many patients we are getting with this. So now, what are the vitamins which will help for this? The literature has been supported regarding vitamin B3, B12, vitamin C. So girls are coming to me that, madam, we have done the Googling and we have started the orgasmic diet. So now how much it is going to help us or not? So showing some slides for that. So now in this orgasmic diet, is as mentioned, the addition of this fish oil, multivitamin, calcium, magnesium, zinc, vitamin C. Avoidance of the trans fats and polyunsaturated fats, including vegetable oils such as corn oil, soybean oil, and safflower. And then eat monounsaturated fats like olive or canola oil or moderate amounts. Eat a 1/2 ounce of the quality dark chocolate every day. Avoid things that interfere with sexual function, including caffeine, cigarettes, and other stimulants, or the exercise of the PC muscles. So, yeah. So the diet which is helpful for increasing the libido, increasing of the sea vegetables, beans, root vegetables, water, spicy foods, dark chocolate, and reduction of the alcohol. Of course, the Kegel exercise also have a very, very important role. So this diagram I have put, especially once the couple is dating, the male always thinking about for this the sex. So now how we manage the sexual dysfunction, how we do the counseling of the patient. First, we have to understand the proper history and proper counseling, and later on the role come for the drugs. So now, sensory to focus exercises, the stage one, it is divided into 4 stages. The stage one, the partners touch each other one by one, whole body, but not the genitalia. In the stage two, they touch each other one by one, whole body, including genitalia. While in 3, the mutual touching simultaneously. While in the stage 4, the engagement and the sexual intercourse. This plan actually has been developed by the Marston and Johnson. So now with some dietary modifications, some are Indian herbs are also has been reported to has been a very, very good results in the cases of the sexual dysfunction. Among this, fenugreek is very, very important. Lot of studies have come. So fenugreek is a herb that has many benefits for the health and well-being. It has played a key role in the alternative medicine for thousands of years. Fenugreek seed extract was found to exhibit the estrogenic activities, including the binding of to estrogen receptors and including the expression of estrogen responsive gene. So the studies have shown that protodiosin enriched extract of fenugreek, it stimulates the release of LH and FSH and the DHT, dihydrotestosterone hormone, which in turn causes 1.74-fold increases the testosterone, and 1.08-fold increases the total testosterone level. So here we can see once this LH, FSH, and DHT levels are increasing, so it increases the sexual desire, sexual motivation, sexual pleasure, and sexual performance. So there are a lot of studies in the favor of this. The effect of trigonella formigerinum seed extract on sex hormones and the sexual function in healthy menstruative women who reported with the low sexual drive. Other herbs which has been reported is the Tribulus terrestris. I hope you all are must aware of this and having more knowledge for this. So the study has been come that Tribulus terrestris influences the libido and this is able to have a boost sex drive in the human being. So it has been considered as a libido booster plant in the woman. Now studies have shown the DHEA also improves the sexual interest and satisfaction among the woman with adrenal insufficiency. So yeah. Again, the another very important which has been reported is the L-citrulline and L-arginine. So coming to this L-citrulline, L-citrulline is a substance which is, has been known as a non-essential amino acid. The sources are the watermelon, garlic, dark chocolate, almonds. They all has been reported as a very good source of this. So we can easily tell our patients to include all this in diet. Besides this, I'm going to include for the one or the two supplements also, which all are containing this. So how this L-citrulline acts? So L-citrulline boosts the nitric oxide production in the body, which helps the arteries to relax and work better. So this L-citrulline and L-arginine mechanism, L-arginine, the stomach, liver, nearly 50% conversation. So of this arginase to ornithine, this L-arginine then causes this nitric oxide production, which increases the relaxes the smooth blood vessels and help in the erection. This helping both in the males and females. So there are a lot of studies have come in the favor of this. So only advantage, earlier we all are giving only L-arginine. Now a lot of studies have come with the benefit of this L-citrulline, because it is not affected in the stomach and liver and directly converted in the kidney, while with L-arginine it is stomach and liver nearly 50% conversation. So another, now a lot of studies have come with the use of this pine bark extract, the endothelium dependent vasodilatation facilitated by the nitric oxide. Among this, the this picogenol has been reported to help a lot. Again, the these two drugs has been reported, the flabiserin, or the name as Addy, but it is currently not available in India. With the dose of 100 mg at bedtime, a non-hormonal centrally acting postsynaptic serotonin 1A receptor agonist and a serotonin 2A receptor antagonist. That results in a decrease in serotonin activity and increase in dopamine and norepinephrine activity. Then studies have come regarding the testosterone gel. So the testosterone therapy is an evidence-based off-label treatment for the perimenopausal and postmenopausal women with HSCD. So history has, and lots of studies have also shown the use of this down 300 mg per day patch. A lot of studies have been reported for this, for the treatment of HSDD. Another very important is the buspirone, a serotonin 1A partial agonistic is approved as an anxiolytic for the management of the generalized anxiety disorder or the short-term relief of the symptoms of anxiety. It has also be used off-label for the treatment of HSDD, as because we all are using as an anxiolytic, so this is also has been used. Now coming to very important, the PRP therapy, what we are using, the benefits of the PRP shots, what we are giving for the sexual dysfunction, which improves the sexual gratification, no downtime, and patient can resume the normal activity and sexual activities immediately, and any no incision has been required for this. So a lot of studies have come for the favor of this PRP having a very excellent result. So this is after giving the PRP, how the patient is, because PRP itself is a one another lecture, so I have to take one more lecture for that. Infertility can be a time significant personal and interpersonal stress for women. So details of sexual function and frequency should be discussed at the initial infertility evaluation to rule out the pre-existing sexual dysfunction. This, I think, very important to discuss the history and do the proper counseling. So if left untreated, the female sexual dysfunction may become a chronic problem and can affect the self-esteem and interpersonal relationships. FSD has a known negative impact on a woman's quality of life. Further research is necessary to provide the optimal management for patients suffering from both FSD and infertility. So whenever the patient comes of the sexual dysfunction, already they are sometimes so many depressed. So first point of the counseling always starts with that you always have to have a keep a positive attitude. A positive attitude will have a positive result because attitudes are contagious. So for this sexual dysfunction, of course, we start the medication, and our counseling will again depends on this, that the couple has to be together and to have a happily life. So thank you, patients, for the, so thank you, dear friends, for having a patient hearing. And thank you for your interest in your time. If any questions, because it's such a vast topic, now I can't cover everything in 1 hour. Such a vast topic, for each and everything, there are full lecture can be given for the dyspareunia, for the vaginismus, lot of details we have to share. So thank you, Dr. Shilpa.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you. I think it's really great. So I request all the doctors to participate in the discussion, because discussion, I think, is the important part of the session. So I directly give you the, allow the unmute, so it's better.
Yeah, sure, not a problem.
Yeah, definitely. Yes, doctors, please unmute yourself and you can communicate directly with ma'am. So,
because this is such the topic now, so many patients are not apne aap se open nahi hote, aapla sagra bichara lagto mag tishanantar patients antar kai kai patients with this dyspareunia, of course we are getting the patient these days.
Yes ma'am, ek aisa kuch there are any diseases like secondary type mein kuch like diabetes ya kuch aise diseases hai?
Yeah. So that I already showed now, for diabetes, hypertension, PCOS, endometriosis, all are affecting. Especially in the diabetes, the patients are coming with this decreased sexual desire. So control of the sugar level is also very, very important in these patients.
Yes.
Similarly, in the hypertension also, we are giving so many drugs. Already have started. So some drugs has a side effect for the decreased sexual desire. So once patient is coming to us, we have to do the proper counseling and to ask properly that which medication. कि बहुत बार patient बताते नहीं हैं. Usually the patients are coming to us. Sometimes the husband is getting that now my wife is not getting the sexual desire.
Yes. Yeah, at the menopausal age, I think this is the most common thing at the perimenopausal.
Yeah. Most commonly they are coming at that time. And similarly, some patients. Means I'm telling you, this is a recent. Earlier क्या होता था कि सब menopause वाले ही वैसे उसमें आते थे, because already the female is having a due to less hormones having a less sexual drive. Now these days means from the couple of last weeks I'm seeing the patients of age group of 28 to 30 years also of this. So yeah. Patients are complaining. Either means wife is saying I'm too much tied up in my office work, huh?
Yeah, so yeah. This is also the common in this new generation. Yeah.
So I am not getting patients are coming us for the infertility treatment. One, then we have to ask properly whether your marriage is consummated or not. This is also a very, very important point. Patient येऊन असं सांगतात, मॅडम आमच्या महिन्याला एक वेळ होतो, महिन्याला दोन वेळ होतो तरी. तो फिर वन्स द गुड डेज दे आर मिसिंग, हाउ द लेडी इज गेटिंग टू बिकम अ प्रेग्नेंट. सो वी हैव टू टेक वन बाय वन. सो मैंने जैसा बोला ना कि हर एक के ऊपर पूरा एक लेक्चर होता है, डॉक्टर शिल्पा, वेजिनिस्मस के ऊपर, डिस्पेरुनिया के ऊपर, फॉर एवरीथिंग. डॉक्टर स्वाति, स्वाति इज रिटन दिस प्रीमैच्योर इजेकुलेशन प्रेजेंट इन फीमेल. डॉक्टर स्वाति, देयर इज नो सच एंटिटी हैज बीन रिपोर्टेड फॉर द फीमेल्स इज प्रीमैच्योर इजेकुलेशन इन फीमेल. इट्स लाइक दैट द गर्ल विल टेल यू, और मीन्स अ गर्ल और द लेडी विल टेल यू कि she is getting wet frequently. Premature ejaculation word has not been used in the science for the females. Yes, agar wo aisa bol rahi hai ki jaldi wet ho jati hai, some girls are complaining us that they are all the time they are wet. This is also a very, very common complaint. So usme pehle humko kuch infection ke liye bhi check karna hai, because sometimes with this PID two kinds of presentation are coming. Usually the some patients are getting excessive discharge. And especially if there's only bacterial vaginosis, then they feel only the transparent vaginal discharge. And we only tell the patient while checking that there is some smell is coming. Kabhi-kabhi to patient khud se batate bhi nahi hai ki smell aa raha hai ki nahi aa raha hai. No, this word, this can't be used for the females. This we keep specifically for the males.
Yes. बट मैम आई थिंक कि इसको हम कुछ अलग टर्मिनोलॉजी में बिठा सकते हैं, लाइक जो अराउज नहीं होना ये बोल सकते ना, वी कैन से दैट
लॉस ऑफ लिबिडो, मतलब जैसे आपने बोला
या स्लो अराउजल,
स्लो अराउजल भी एक्चुअली वर्ड ऐसा नहीं है, आप HSDD हाइपोएक्टिव सेक्सुअली डिजायर डिसऑर्डर उसमें आप
हाइपोएक्टिव वी कैन से
यस यू कैन से हाइपोएक्टिव या हाय डॉक्टर कुसुम थैंक यू फॉर ज्वाइनिंग डॉक्टर यस थायराइड इज ऑफ कोर्स कॉजिंग द हाइपोथायरॉइडिज्म इज ऑफ कोर्स कॉजिंग द डिक्रीज सेक्सुअल डिजायर यस द स्टडीज हैज बीन रिपोर्टेड so if the patient is coming with this thyroid issues yes of course there is decreased sexual.
How can we go through ma'am then how can we go through because I think thyroid dysfunction is much more common in females
here to you have to give this thyroid supplement only but patient cha kaha hai ki ye thyroid cha tumhala proper control kara lage baki kuch alag uske liye nahi hai all the other supplements what I told you that like a dietary changes as I told you this dark because I have seen my so many patients have got a very good results with this dark chocolate khane ko bhi wo aaram se bahut ready ho jate and with dark chocolate garlic to sabke khane mein hota hi hai ha with dark chocolate
and so
with watermelon ke bahut hi acche results aate hain fir this I am telling you from last 2 years I am giving these to my so many of patients and we are, and dark chocolate to the entire mala patient la sangtat so we you have to tell about the cocoa percentage should be more than 70-80% kyunki jab chocolate mein log lete dark chocolate to bahut sare available hai market mein 20% dark chocolate hai 30% hai so then that the concentration of the cocoa should be up to 70-90% that will give the good results along with the aapka thyroid control karne ke sath mein
Yes, and dark chocolate is, I think, mostly used by the marketing companies to advertise such type of issues, and as a law of fiction, के लिए भी इसका बहुत ज़्यादा dark chocolate is used very much, I think, for such purpose also. So there is a science also behind the using of this dark chocolate, and I think dark chocolate is really good for women also for anti-aging. Vitamin E is there. It is enriched with vitamin E also. तो जो एंटीऑक्सीडेंट के तौर पे भी काम करता है डार्क चॉकलेट इज आल्सो देयर
ट्रू ट्रू
यस यस एनी मोर क्वेश्चंस डॉक्टर्स मैम कैन यू सजेस्ट समथिंग आर देयर लाइक समथिंग स्पेशल पोजीशंस एंड आसनास आर देयर लाइक इन आयुर्वेदा आल्सो देयर आर
मेनी आई विल टेक वन अनदर लेक्चर फॉर दैट द सेक्सुअल पोजीशन देयर इज डेफिनेट different lecture in this because I today covered only for the infertility because for the infertility what we usually suggest as you asked me what the position so usually the missionary position only we are saying if the patient is not comfortable in that then side by side position is also good because there is ek puri entity aati hai Dr. Shilpa isme ki different sexual
position. Yeah no and I think all these all depends upon the psycho condition mainly the psycho condition is necessary so मोटिवेशन या उनके बीच में ही खुद से होना चाहिए वो भाव तो फिर बाकी किसी चीज की जरूरत नहीं भी बाकी किसी आहार की भी जरूरत नहीं नो अदर थिंग्स आर रिक्वायर्ड एक्चुअली
वेरी ट्रू बट दिस यूजुअली द डॉक्टर कुसुम माय सम ऑफ माय लेक्चर्स ऑन माय यूट्यूब सो आपको जिसमें से आप भी जो लोग भी देखना चाहे दे कैन गो थ्रू फॉर माय माय यूट्यूब चैनल देयर आर लॉट ऑफ लेक्चर्स इन दैट सो among the sexual dysfunction and so many things I have taken so plus I have put my whatsapp number here those who want to become a Dr. Shilpa ko to main add kar dungi aaj I am having lot of academic groups where we are doing only the wholesale academic discussions so those who want to become a member of academic group can just whatsapp me on this number please whatsapp me with your name and your workplace so I can add you accordingly in that group So,
yes, ma'am. One question is there on Facebook also. In spite of dark chocolate, can we use a cocoa powder?
You can use, not a problem. You can use a cocoa powder, but you have to see the cocoa powder which one you are using. So you have to check the cocoa content in that. That how much is the cocoa content in that? So just as I just specified, must be 70-90% of the cocoa content.
Yes.
Chocolate powder we are getting so many na so many in the market we are getting so you have to see the cocoa content in that
yes ma'am as per your experience jo bhi drugs wagera prescribe hote hain सो इज देयर एनी रियली रोल और कुछ साइड इफेक्ट्स भी होंगे अगर हमने कुछ इस प्रकार से?
देखिए कोई ऐसी ड्रग आती ही नहीं है, अभी मैंने सबको बताया हम लोग भी जो देते हैं बहुत सारी ना हर्बल प्रिपरेशन देते हैं, बट बीइंग एलोपैथिक डॉक्टर आई कांट टेक दैट हर्बल प्रिपरेशन नेम ऑन द प्लेटफॉर्म, सो क्योंकि हमको अलाउड नहीं है क्योंकि पेशेंट को बहुत सारे हम आई एम टेलिंग यू द फैक्ट बिकॉज हम बहुत सारे पेशेंट्स को हम ये डायट्री मॉडिफिकेशन बताते हैं जो मैंने बताया, इसके बहुत सारे सप्लीमेंट बिकॉज नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड के बहुत सारे सप्लीमेंट है व्हाट वी आर यूजिंग फॉर द इनफर्टिलिटी ट्रीटमेंट आल्सो वी आर यूजिंग एंड वी आर यूजिंग फॉर दिस इंक्रीजिंग द एंडोमेट्रियल थिकनेस आल्सो, तो उसमें नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड के लिए हम बहुत सारी चीजें देते हैं, सो दैट अर्लियर वी आर गिविंग दिस आर्जिनिन, नाउ वी आर गिविंग दिस सिट्रुलिन सप्लीमेंट्स आल्सो, प्लस इसके अलावा बहुत सारे हर्ब्स आते हैं, इसीलिए मैंने स्पेशली वो इसका मेथी का डाला था कि वी आर यूजिंग लॉट ऑफ एक्सट्रैक्ट ऑफ दैट, द कैप्सूल्स आर कमिंग विद 500 mg BD, तो हम बहुत सारे यूज करते हैं ऐसे. आप मुझे बताओ आप किसी कोई ऐसे और कौन से यूज करते हो बेटर?
देर आर सो मेनी कल्पास, देर आर सो मेनी प्रिपरेशन, सो मेनी प्रिपरेशन विच एक्ट्स ऑन द वेरियस पार्ट्स लाइक द स्पर्म मोर्टेलिटी, स्पर्म काउंट रिड्यूस हुआ है तो उसके ऊपर काम करने के लिए, फीमेल सेक्सुअल डिसफंक्शन में भी वी यूज द शतावरी, द अश्वगंधा आल्सो, देर आर मेनी साइंटिफिक डिस्क्रिप्शन इन अवर संहिता, सो वी यूज ऑल्सो एंड दिस ऑल कंपाउंड और द हर्बल ड्रग्स वी यूज इन बोथ द पार्टनर्स मेल एंड फीमेल्स, जो भी हम लोग प्रिस्क्राइब करते हैं तो दोनों में ही करते हैं बिकॉज इन आयुर्वेदा देर आर 7 धातु टिश्यूज एंड द शुक्रा, सो शुक्र धातु इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर द फीमेल ऑल्सो बिकॉज द अदर फंक्शंस नॉट द रिप्रोडक्शन बट द अदर फंक्शंस आर कंसर्न विद द दिस शुक्र धातु, सो वी लुक एज द ओवरऑल टॉनिक, ओवरऑल टोन टू यूटरस एंड द रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम,
करेक्ट?
Such a type. One question is there again, for how long we have to give it to the patient?
What do
you... chocolate या कुछ भी अगर हम देते हैं diet suggest करेंगे तो
chocolate का कुछ problem नहीं है, you can give up to 6 weeks to 12 weeks. Usually once the patient is coming to us, what the prescription what we give along with this dilators, usually the first follow up we call only after 6 weeks. You can give up to this 12 weeks also, not a problem. वो देख लो पेशेंट डायबिटिक ना हो, फिर ऐसा ना हो कि वो ऐसा बोले कि आपने बोला था डॉग चॉकलेट खाने के लिए आप, तो वी हैव टू चेक ऑल दैट, बाकी नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम. सिमिलरली द सिट्रुलिन व्हाट वी आर गिविंग इज अ एंटीऑक्सीडेंट, सो नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम फॉर दैट, वी दैट आल्सो वी कैन गिव लॉन्ग टाइम आल्सो. तो यूजुअली वंस वी ट्रीटिंग द सेक्सुअल डिसफंक्शन प्रॉब्लम्स, यूजुअली वी कॉल द पेशेंट्स आफ्टर 4 weeks और 6 weeks, यूजुअली द फॉलो अप विजिट इज देयर.
यस मैम, यस. जो एक ये होगा वो तो नेचुरल कुछ होगा ही, एट द एज ऑफ मेनोपॉज डिमिनिश होगा ही सेक्सुअल फंक्शन, जो होगा वो थोड़ा कम ही होगा, बिल्कुल नेचुरल है वो तो.
तो इसके लिए हम कुछ पेशेंट्स में वी आर गिविंग इन द पेरीमेनोपॉजल एज ग्रुप, इफ द पेशेंट सम पेशेंट्स वी आर गिविंग द एस्ट्रोजन सप्लीमेंट्स, सम पेशेंट्स वी आर गिविंग द टिबोलोन, सम पेशेंट्स वी आर गिविंग SERM इनहिबिटर्स वी आर गिविंग, एंड इन सम पेशेंट्स वी आर गिविंग दिस PRP थेरेपी व्हाट आई डिस्क्राइब, सो मींस अकॉर्डिंग टू द पेशेंट्स वी आर डिसाइडिंग एंड गिविंग. या
ओके, यस. आर देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस डॉक्टर? सो वी आर एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन.
हेलो मैम.
यस
डॉक्टर. मैम सेकेंडरी इनफर्टिलिटी में भी इतना ही इफेक्टिव रहेगा ये जो आप बता रही हैं?
ऑफ कोर्स सेकेंडरी इनफर्टिलिटी में भी इफेक्टिव रहेगा, बट इन द सेकेंडरी इनफर्टिलिटी कि मैम यू हैव टू सी फॉर दिस एनी PID और एनी एंडोमेट्रियोसिस आल्सो.
Because that cases are more like na secondary.
Yeah. So yeah, if the PID is there, then first you have to treat the PID and then you have to go for that. डॉक्टर कुसुम इज राइटिंग अबाउट द कॉफी, सो कॉफी के लिए ऐसा नहीं है कुछ स्टडी रिपोर्टेड नहीं है डॉक्टर कुसुम,
बट लाइक ऐसे मतलब एज पर लाइक ऐसे बताया जाता है ना कि जैसे चॉकलेट्स वगैरह दिया जाता है तो कॉफी टाइम एंड लाइक कॉफी ऑल्सो वर्क्स एज अ स्टिम्यूलेंट.
Lot of things are there if you find, but abhi, if I am taking a lecture, I have to give you the all proof that what is the incidence, what is the studies have there. सो मुझे वो स्टडीज के हिसाब से बोलना है, तो कॉफी के लिए तो मुझे ऐसा स्टडी नहीं मिला है.
Another question, any more questions?
This is actually OPT time, na? This is not correct time for keeping the lecture.
Yeah, I understand. And thank you very much for your time, ma'am, because I know it's a OPT timing. आपका बहुत बहुत आभार व्यक्त करती हूँ. और अगले भी कुछ सेशंस आपसे मैं बिल्कुल एक मांगूंगी कि फिर से एक बार अलग अलग ऐसे ही विषयों पर कुछ सेशंस होंगे तो बहुत हमारे लिए भी कुछ एक थोड़ा सा. और इस ये लेक्चर रखने का ये भी एक ये है कि जो थोड़ा स्टिम्युलेट हो जाएगा अलग अलग जो सब्जेक्ट्स है. आज सोशल अगर हम देखेंगे समाज में तो काफी सारे ऐसे कुछ इश्यूज होते हैं बट लोग बोल नहीं पाते हैं. तो इस तरफ से भी हमें जब हम इस हिस्ट्री लेंगे पेशेंट्स की इनफर्टिलिटी की तो इस प्रकार से भी हमें सोचना चाहिए. यहाँ तक हमें पहुंचना है, यहाँ तक पहुंचने का ये हमें थोड़ा सा ये मिल जाएगा, एक रास्ता मिल जाएगा कि ये हिस्ट्री में हम भी ये भी इंक्लूड करें. बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द थिंग आई ऑलवेज ऑब्जर्व दैट हम ये भूल ही जाते हैं, ये पूछना हम भूल ही जाते हैं. बाकी सब कुछ हम कराते रहते हैं, मेडिसिन देते हैं, आयुर्वेद के हिसाब से भी ट्रीटमेंट करते रहते हैं, बट ये भी एक मेन पार्ट है तो इसको भी हमें भूलना नहीं है. और ये भी हम लोग बेहतरीन तरीके से अभी आगे चलकर काउंसलिंग या जो भी मैडम ने बताया उस प्रकार से हम इसको ट्रीट कर पाएंगे. बिल्कुल डेफिनेटली. या so thank you very much.
Thank you Dr. Shilpa, and thank you all the friends who have taken out their time.
Thank you. So we are ending the session. Namaskar sabhi ko, abhar, dhanyawad,
bye
bye.